was born in 1750, a Bidjigal man, in a town north of the Georges River near what is now known as Bodning Bay. His name originates from the Darug word Pemul, meaning earth. Pemulwuy spoke one of the many Darug dialects. Pemulwuy was recognized by his characteristic blemish on the left eye. Not much is known about Pemulwuy's family life, only that he had one son. However, there is an abundance of information available on the brave warrior and how he came to receive this title and fight for the original owners of the land. Pemulwuy, as a powerful Aboriginal leader, led many resistance movements against the British settlers. The major movement he led was that of the Eora Nation against the European expansion into the Eora lands. Every resistance movement Pemulwuy led gradually made him into the man of both myth and legend within both Aboriginal and settler communities. From 1792, Pemulwuy led a number of raids on Prospect, Toongabie, Georges River, Parramatta, Brickfield, and the Hawkesbury River. Pemulwuy's retaliations were extremely significant as they were the largest organized Aboriginal retaliation movements, with groups of over 100 people fighting from different clans within the Aboriginal culture. During these years, Pemulwuy was shot numerous times, but with his survival came a recurring conspiracy within his people that he possessed a spiritual protection from these guns. Spiritual protection that all Aboriginal people wanted.
Pemulwuy's immediate reaction to the British settlers was one of retribution, the need for him and his Aboriginal people to fight back and to regain their rightful land. Pemulwuy recognized the actions of the settlers and what they wanted to achieve by colonizing Australia and ruining Aboriginal culture, and he thought it necessary to take a stand. The British settlers and the Aboriginals were in constant battle, whether it be with words or with actions, though unlike many others, Pemulwuy was confident enough to stand for what he believed in. Pemulwuy was no doubt a brave warrior, a man who gathered his people, his broken culture, and rebuilt a stronger army to take on that of the settlers.
Pemulwuy showed the Aboriginals how to fight the British settlers and attempt to retake control of their home, of their land. He was the first to take a stand, the first to fight back, and that is the main reason he is still such a prominent historical Aboriginal figure today. The civil interactions between Aboriginal and non-Aboriginal, the British settler people, were already non-existent. Pemulwuy merely gave Aboriginals a chance to retaliate with his numerous missions. Pemulwuy died in approximately 1802, having lived to survive over 7 gunshot wounds and escaping after a short time in prison. He was, and most definitely still is, an extraordinary man, a brave warrior of the Aboriginal people and culture.